When I'm talking about Prim-Zilgarodham, what happens here is, in Kruskal-Zilgarodham, we arrange the edges in minimum order and pick up the edge with the minimum weight one by one by one. This is not what happens in Prim's. Prim's may, instead of beginning with the edges, we begin with the nodes. So we begin with, supposedly I'm beginning with node A. So I pick up the node A and I try to see which is the edge which is starting from A and which is having minimum weight. So there are three edges coming out of A. Possibility is A to E, A to D and A to B. There are three possible edges from A. The edge with the minimum weight is A to E. So I pick up the edge with the minimum weight and add it to my minimum spanning tree. This edge is picked and this is added to the minimum spanning tree. Now I will check all the edges which are adjacent to the current tree. So if I'm checking all the edges which are adjacent to the current tree, how many edges will be there? There are a lot of edges now. Possibility is B to D, B to C. Again, D is a part of the tree now. Sorry. A to E I have picked up. My mistake. So sorry. A to E se jo adjacent edges are still. A to B is a possible edge. A to D is a possible edge. Then I'm having E to D possible edge and E to C possible edge. So there are four possible edges here. Two coming out from A and two coming out from E. Having a weight 2, 2, 6 and 3. So I can pick either of these edges since they are having the same weight. Either I pick A to B or I pick A to D. Randomly I will be picking some edge. Supposedly I am picking the edge A to B. And I add it to the graph because it is going to add a different vertex which has not yet been covered. Since B has not yet been covered in the graph, so I am adding it. Now I check all the edges which are possibly adjacent to the given tree which has been covered. So if I will now be checking the possible adjacent edges to my given tree, which is A, B, E, I have found. The next possibility is adjacent edges possible from this tree will be all the edges possible from A to different nodes. Now, possible edges is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 now. Now, I have to check minimum out of these. 3, 6, 2, 4, and 5. So, minimum is 2. Can clearly see. So, I pick the edge with the minimum weight. So, I'm picking the edge with the minimum weight and I'm including this in my minimum spanning tree. I hope you all are understanding. Again, we will be checking all the edges which are just going out from this tree connecting to a node which has not been covered already. So, C has already not been covered. The possible three adjacent edges coming to C are E to C, D to C and B to C. Out of these, which is the minimum weight? 6, 4 and 5. So, I pick the edge with the weights 4. So, I am picking the edge with weight 4. And all the vertices have now been covered in the graph. I have reached my minimum spanning tree. This is how I proceed in Prim's algorithm. Again, a greedy algorithm. Again, the only thing I am doing is, instead of picking edges, I am picking vertices. And from every vertex, I choose an edge with minimum weight. Minimum weight connecting to a vertex that is already not a part of my minimum spanning tree. When I am adding an edge to the spanning tree, I check again for all the possible edges which are adjacent to the tree, entire tree. Any edge with minimum weight which is adjacent to the tree connecting to a node already not connected in the tree is included, otherwise excluded. Is the concept clear? Should I now give the algorithm? So what happens in Prim's algorithm is, this is my Prim's algorithm which is beginning. So this is my first step, second step and so on. What is happening in the algorithm is, I'm calling the Prim's algorithm for a graph G with G with the set of edges E and vertices V, weight, set of weights on every edge, and R is the root node from which I'm beginning. Since it's Prim's algorithm, I can begin with any alphabetical order if no node is given. So that is not an issue. For each node belonging to the set of vertices V in the graph, initially the key value is infinite. Parent is nil. And the root node can be reached with zero key value. So the key value for the root is zero. We'll see what the key value is. Key value is only we are adding from at what distance are we able to reach from source to the particular node, nothing else. So I add all the vertices in a queue. all the vertices. Then while Q is not empty, I am extracting minimum key value vertex from the queue. Initially, all other vertices are at infinite key. Only root is at zero. So root will be extracted initially. Then all the vertices adjacent to the node U, which is in our case, will be the root node initially. We check for all adjacent vertices if the adjacent vertex is already in queue, matlab it is not visited yet, it has not been included in my spanning tree yet, and the weight of whatever edge we are picking is less than current key value that can be reached. If it is less, that means we have to include it, and we include that, change the parent and update the key value for the particular vertex, otherwise not. Continue repeating the process and I will be able to find my minimum spanning tree. If I look at the complexity of the current algorithm, initialization, this part of my initialization, this is taking of the order V time because it is for each vertex in the graph. So it is taking of the order V time. Again, after initialization, if I am taking the time taken to extract minimum from the queue. So at most, all the elements in the queue will have to be seen. So if I am taking this all, if I am taking this particular loop, it is running again of the order V time. Jitne vertices hain graph mein, to extract minimum, I will again take of the order V time. And if I am taking time for each adjacent node, again for each adjacent node, I have to take all in all the loops, maximum how many adjacent nodes are possible? That is the number of edges in the graph. A yes or no? Maximum possible, kitne adjacent yahan pe check ho sakte hain, jitni edges in graph mein. So this is maximum e possible times over all the loops. Now if I'm trying to add this, if I'm trying to see, and if I'm trying to say ki this is I'm representing as a heap or something, so log v time mein we are able to achieve this particular thing, then for v into log v plus e I'm having, can you see that the complexity that I'm trying to calculate? A yes or no?
Yes ma'am.
So the complexity that we are coming at is,
yes ma'am,
so the complexity that we finally come at is almost coming out to be v log v only plus e log v, which in worst case again will come out to be v square log v, or we can say slight betterment. If we are correctly implementing this heap, then the complexity will be v log of log v or e log of log v, either case I can say. So the complexity will be e log of log v or v log of log v, which is slightly better than the Kruskal's algorithm, which is, both are greedy approaches, but the approach is ki humne wahan pe initially pura ka pura, we were arranging in decreasing order, non-decreasing order by weight. Here we are not arranging everything. We are just checking each edge as and when it is coming. Hum koi arrange nahi kar rahe hain. We are just checking each edge as and which we are coming. Now the crux of this algorithm's better complexity is, why is the complexity better? Because in a dense graph, the number of edges is greater than the number of vertices. Clearly, edges zyada hain, tabhi to we are looking at finding a minimum spanning tree. So since the number of edges is greater than the number of vertices, we are not arranging the edges. Arranging a larger data structure will take more time na, so we are not arranging the edges. Hum kya kar rahe hain? Hum minimum of queue extract kar rahe hain, jisme hame kam time lag raha hai as compared to arranging the edges. And we are picking up each and every edge as and when it is coming. That is why the complexity is slightly better over the Kruskal's algorithm. Is it clear to all?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So let's see the same example for solving. I hope the algorithm is also clear to all of you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so let's see the same example for solving using the Prim's approach, or do I give you another example so that you can practice both of them from the opposite?
Yes, ma'am.
I'll just give you another example so that when you practice, you have two options to practice from. So supposedly you are having a graph, again A, B, C,
some D. I'm just connecting them. E, F, and some G is also here. So supposedly all of them are connected with some edges, and the weight on each of the edges is mentioned somewhere, giving you the weight on each edge. You can begin with any route which you are taking. I'm again saying, generally it might be mentioned, it might not be mentioned, will not make a change at all in the solution. So supposedly this is my given graph. I'm going to pick up an edge every time and I'm going to check the key value and the parent value. So let's try picking up from A only. Let's begin from A. What is happening is, initially when I'm picking up from A, initially key value for A is 0. All others are at infinite. Initially all others are at infinite key, right? So when I'm picking A, now A ke adjacent jitne bhi edges, I will pick them one by one by one. There are two edges. Can you see two edges? Initially I will be picking one edge, then I will be picking second edge. Supposedly I pick A to F. Since I'm picking A to F, the edge, what is happening here? I am checking whether whatever edge I'm picking, F is now currently at infinite. If you recall, I was checking whether this F is belonging to Q. All the elements, abhi Q mein kya hai? A, B, C, D, E, F, G. All are part of my Q. A ko humne bahar nikal liya hai. Baki sab to abhi bhi Q ka hi part hai. So, now after A, I'm reaching F. Since I'm picking the edge, AF first. Randomly AF pick karo ya AB pick karo, doesn't make a difference. I will be picking both. So I'm picking AF. F is still a part of the Q. Correct. The condition is true. First condition is F belonging to Q is true. Next condition is weight on the edge UV, which is weight on the edge AF. This is less than the key of my particular node F. Now key of F is infinite. Weight on AF is 25. 25 is less than infinite. This is true. Since this is true, parent of F becomes A, and this particular key value of F is updated to be 25. Correct? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
I pick up the another edge. Now I pick up the edge A to B. After picking the edge A to B, again B I am reaching, I will be, since infinite se kam hai, I will be updating the distance as 20 and I will be updating the parent as A. Now, from the A has come out. Now, out of all the nodes in my queue, B is having the value 10, F is having the value 25, rest all are having infinite value. So I'm extracting minimum. The next node that I'm extracting is B. This is understood? Next node being extracted is B. A extract ho gaya, B extract ho gaya. Ab B ke adjacent dekhna hai, hame kitni possible edges hain. B ke adjacent only one possible edge is left, which is connecting B to C. So I will be reaching B to C. I will be updating now. B to C is key value kya ho jayegi? The weight on the edge. This becomes 28 instead of infinite. Right? Are you all understanding?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes,
so I'm able to reach C in 28 currently, since it was infinite. Yes. Any doubt? And the parent of C becomes B. Now, again, no other edge is possible from B. I'm done here. I come again. Now there is 25 key value for F, 28 key value for C. So I will pick up F. Minimum value pick karna, so I will be picking up F. After picking up F, I take the edges which are going from the F. E and G are the edges. Both will be updated. Infinite say, E ki value will be updated to be 22 and G's value will be updated to be 24. Right? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Next, when I move again to the algorithm, I will be picking
E, which is having 22, 22, 24, 28, मुझे 22 is the least. I will pick E. So I am now picking E, which is at 22 and which is having a parent as F. E or F के parent, E or G के parent F है. Now I check all the possible edges from E. The only there are two possible edges, E to G and E to D. अब यहाँ पे देखो, when I am reaching E to G, G is there in the queue. Yes, G is still there in the queue. First condition is true. G is there in the queue. Next condition is that the key value of my G, which is currently 24, I have to check this na. This value should be less than, technically this should be less than the value of WUV, which is, WUV is 18 in our case. This condition is not true. That means I will update. This is the condition that I am checking to update. Since I can reach G in lesser distance, lesser key than from F, I will update the parent of G to be, parent of G gets updated to be E and key of G gets updated to be WEG. That means G, I am now reaching in 18. G's key is replaced to be 18 and parent of G is now made as E. ठीक है?
Yes, ma'am.
Now I pick the next edge from E, which is E to D. E to D is again, D is still at infinite. So I will definitely be picking that edge and I will be, so D ka parent becomes E and the weight becomes 12. I again move again. Again try to see what is left in the queue. I will pick 12. Now C, D and G are left only. 12, 18 and 28. So 12 is the least. I will be picking D. So I pick D, which I reached from E, which is at 12 distance here. Now I have to check the edges which are coming out from D. D to C, if you can see. D to C again, I'm picking the edge DC, which is the only edge from D. Now again, C is there in the queue. Yes, C is still there in the queue. And C is there in the queue, because uski sari adjacent edges abhi tak cover nahi hui hai. And when I'm checking that weight on CD, this particular edge is 80, weight is 18. This is less than the key of C. What is the key of C here? 28. This is again true. Change the parent of C to be D and update the value 28 to be 18. So you reach D to C here. Change the parent of C to be D and update the value to be 18. Ye clear hua sabko? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Now again, there is no other edge from D which is still there. So we are done. We again move back. C or G, dono ka hi 18 hai. You can pick any. Supposedly I am picking C. You can pick any, would not make a difference. Again, you can reach C to G. Baki dono edges to we have checked. C to G can be reached in 14. That means you will update this also. And C to G is reached in 14. And the parent of G is changed to be C. अगर आप G को pick करते तो G to C हो जाता, parent of C G हो जाता, बात वहीं की वहीं थी. Either of the edge would have been replaced. This becoming my final minimum spanning tree. Is it clear to all? This gives me the final minimum spanning tree. Are you all understanding how we have created this? Should I take one more example?
Ma'am, it is clear now.
It is clear. Please try the example that we have done for Kruskal's using the prims also. You will be getting a very similar answer. If there is any doubt regarding anything, kindly ask.